Let's move to Kennesaw State next, which arguably last year was the most improved team in the A-Sun. Their second-year head coach is Agnes Marinato. Agnes, tell me, in that first year of the program, what types of things do you think you established going forward for this year and years to come?
Great question. I think what we established for this year and for years to come is maybe a culture. And I think it's a culture that we can compete in the A-Sun and we can be a player. You know, they never really had that here before. And we had big thoughts and big hopes and big dreams. And I think when we got into the conference, some of our players were able to see that come to fruition. And I just think that the conference is so great, but it's pretty top heavy. And so for us to get into the top was really, it was huge for us.
You finished with a winning record in conference, but you only have four players from that team that are back. Tell me a little bit about the challenge of really almost working anew to a point.
Well, that's a good thing. You know, I think new is good. Change is good. A lot of people fear it, but I love it. It's awesome. Claire Young is my point guard, and she'll be back, and she led the troops. She's our only starter back from last year. So I don't know what she averaged, like 8 points. So well, we got about 64, 65 to make up, but no problem. We got some good freshmen coming in. And it's a great challenge. And you know what? We'll just see. It's an opportunity for all of the young kids to step up and get their name in the lights.
And you've got a kid who maybe didn't start last year, but Carlotta Gianola really was a big piece of the puzzle as a standout freshman.
She is a terrific kid. You know, she's a great young lady on and off the court. I know you all like her on the court, and the A-Sun has done an amazing job. And I want to give shout-outs to the A-Sun and all your video people, because all your little Instagrams and your Twitter, your clips, I watch them. I think they're awesome. So kudos to you for that. You make Carlotta look really good. But she is a great player. She's much, much improved. She went on this summer and she made the 20 and under Italian national team that competed for the European Championships. When I went over to Portugal to watch her play, her coaches said she's the most improved American that they have seen. And so we're really happy and we're excited. We're looking forward to her to having a good year. And you know, she missed the whole first semester because she had her arm pulled out of the socket. So this year she's stronger, she's working hard, and she's really ready to compete for the entire season.
And for the new kids you have this year, who do you think can contribute immediately?
I think as far as contributing immediately will be a freshman, Kamaya Street. She's out of Mays, which is a local school here. This kid has 5 state championships to her name. She's a little tiny tot. I mean, maybe about 5'4", but she's explosive. She can score. She can handle the ball. She's just a baller, like a gym rat. She also is a state champion in track in the 300 hurdles and the 4x1. So she'll also do track for us. Alexis Poole. I think Alexis Poole was a freshman down from Stockbridge. I coached her mom at Georgia Tech, which is crazy, and it just tells you how old I am. But Alexis is an unbelievable athlete like her mom, but she's taller, she's sleeker. She probably has a little bit more skill, but she definitely has her mom's heart and work ethic. And then I would have to say a junior college transfer, Janaya Musi from out in California, San Diego. She's from Saddlebrook, and she's just, again, another really fun kid. You look at her and you just laugh because she just brings excitement to the game. So we have a lot, all of our kids are new, honestly, but I think those three will really stand out.
And those new players will get a look at college basketball immediately with some challenges, including Clemson to open the season on November the 10th.